All right, everybody, right now I want to do something a little bit different, which is I want to give you a tour of the Channel Fireball website. I'm really excited because we recently removed the paywall from Channel Fireball, so everything's free now, all the written content. And this means both like the new stuff that's coming out, you know, Seth's best standard decks or Andrea's deck guide on Legacy Scam. All that stuff's free, but also importantly, the whole archive of content, which is like literally years of content from a team of, you know, 10, 15, 20 of the best writers in the game. So you can access all that stuff immediately anytime you want. So let me show you kind of what the layout of the website is for those who might not have made a habit of coming to check it out. But compared to other, you know, Magic content websites, like for example, I write for both Channel Fireball and TCG Player Infinite, but what I personally like and what we've gotten good feedback about in the Channel Fireball website is that it's sortable. So you see all these tabs up top, like, you know, for various games, you link to the TCG Player Marketplace. Edge is, this is the one thing on Channel Fireball that is still a subscription product, but these are really good educational video series. And then there's like the library, the archive up here, you can sort articles, videos, and our search tabs. And then what I'm really talking about is sorting by the formats. So you can go like whatever you like to play or whatever you want to find about, you can go browse that. So let's say, you know, the new set came out and you're trying to brush up on Limited, you can just go to the Limited tab and find like the set guides and whatever else people have released recently. So that's cool. And then I really like the search function, which is something I want to show off. You can use like the bar up here or the deck search. But a couple like categories of articles that you might enjoy, deck guides. That's sort of our classic like bread and butter. So let's go back to the main page and click on Andrea's most recent deck guides. This is going to be about Legacy Scam. And then you scroll down, you get the deck list, you get his thoughts and reasons for card choices, tips and tricks. And then what a lot of people like is the sideboard guide. So, you know, if you are playing with a new deck, trying to get a crash course, and you're like, you know, how can I improve my equity really quick? You can just see, you know, search for the deck that you're interested in, see if we have a deck guide for it. Check out the deck list and the sideboard guide and use that as a reference. Another type of article that I use personally is the power rankings. So I personally have written the standard, legacy, vintage, sometimes modern power rankings. Frank does the pioneer power rankings. Of those, I would say modern and standard, we keep like the most current, but I like to just reference these. For example, let's say this is actually a real life thing that happened the other day. I'll use it as an example. Is I was building a modern deck for a league. I had 14 sideboard cards that I was happy with, and I'm like, okay, you know, what should I use my 15th sideboard slot on? Let me get a quick refresh of what decks I'm likely to face. So I went to the modern tab. I found Andrea's most recent modern deck guide or power rankings. I scrolled to the bottom, you know, because it's sorted in order of what he believes are the most important decks in the format. So I'm like, okay, Crashing Footfalls, you know, Violent Outburst recently got banned, whatever, the Cascade decks. So I'm scrolling through his power rankings, and I'm like, okay, there's no Urza's Saga decks in the top, you know, 7, 8, 9, 10 of his power rankings. So that means it's probably not a good week to use a sideboard slot on Ancient Grudge. So then I decided not to use Ancient Grudge. And I'm scrolling through and I'm like, oh, I forgot about Amulet Titan. That's a really big deck now. I need to have a plan for that. So then I decided that I was going to use my extra slot on an Ashiok Dream Render or, you know, whatever card is good against Amulet. That's just an example of something that you can use the power rankings for as just like a quick and dirty refresh or entry point into the format, you know, what kind of stuff do I need to think about? Then the third type of article that you're going to be interested in is deep dive. So these are our ones that are like not deck specific, not format specific, evergreen, kind of like long-term improvements type stuff. So anytime you feel like maybe you're at a sticking point in terms of improving at Magic, you can find a deep dive. Like, okay, I'm playing Legacy on stream today. How to master Brainstorm in Magic, deep dive. So this is a huge, detailed, long article about like all the corner cases, everything I can think of to improve your experience and, you know, make you a better player for when you're using a Brainstorm deck. So that's just an example of, you know, the type of stuff you can search for on the website. By the way, I do, you know, I'll take this moment to make it clear. I do work for Channel Fireball and TCG Player, but on the other hand, like, nobody's asking me to do this. I'm not getting paid extra for it. So when you see, you know, me or one of the other writers promoting Channel Fireball on our personal social media, you know, Twitch, Twitter, whatever it might be, that's a lot of times just because, like, we actually are proud of the work that we're doing on Channel Fireball, and we think a lot of people can benefit from it and enjoy it, and we want it to reach a wider audience. So that's kind of what I have for you today. I just wanted to show that off. And if you're not in the habit of using Channel Fireball as a resource, I would definitely encourage you to stop by and see if there's something cool that you might enjoy.